But I want to say, I had this thought at the beginning of the week. I actually wrote it for the article that's in our paper in a couple weeks. And I just couldn't let it go about making memories. And we enjoy memories, and God gives us memories for a reason, and memories fashion who we are, right? And so I started looking through. I was going to bring a picture book here and memories and kind of flick through it. And I stumbled over a directory that was printed right before I came. And it was just fun because immediately your mind goes to the whole family, right? Isn't that cool? What about... It's funny how Kevin looks the same up top. Anyway, look at John. Doesn't he look dapper there, man? Kids are young. People, this one here, especially Nick. Isn't that awesome? Jamie, look at there. She hasn't changed a bit, has she, Jamie? And then look at this. This one looks like some famous painter, doesn't he? No, the waterfall over here. You just make it your own. Can't you see Mike doing it? Anyway, Jody, I like this one because Keith is still rocking the same hairdo. Making lifelong memories. Memories are good for us. And you know, I can remember years ago when we would go visit like Joyce's dad, mom, and he would be just done watching a VHS from a year ago that he, you know, had the big camera, walked around, and that's how they did it in the old days. And they recorded it right on the VHS thing, and he'd be watching it. I'm like, really? How could you watch these videos? It's you know, and but the older you get, looking in picture books and remembering what has happened becomes something fairly cool. And God gives us our memories, and they're for a blessing. Sometimes some memories are hurtful, but all of the memories makes us who we are, right? Memories of your parents. Today is my dad's birthday. I only know that because I'm on Facebook and my sisters post stuff, because I just don't remember dates. I didn't remember his birth date when he was alive. And so it'd really be sad if I only remembered it after he was gone. But she put a picture on there of my dad sitting at a corner of a picnic table with a Pabst Blue Ribbon. And it just... My whole childhood is right there, because that was the picnic table at Kent Lake that he would take us to, and he would sit there. The good part is she found the picture with his shirt on, so it looked a little better, because usually it wasn't there. But your children, you, all these memories, some of you parents right now who are dying for a night's sleep, they will become memories that you cherish and go, "Woo, we did it." And praise God. Homes you lived in, right? If you lived in different homes, and this morning I looked over at Bob, I'm going, okay, you don't, but most people live on average in 12 different homes. They make 12 different moves. And then you drive, you know, you go and drive where you used to live, and those memories kind of come back to you, and it's like, oh, I remember when, whatever. And it just happens. All the jobs you had form memories, wherever you worked, some good, some bad. You know, I remember when I worked here, and it's always, if you know, you're always this employee that would have turned the company around if they would have just kept you, right? The jobs you were at, vacations you've been on, relatives, right? I'm not all that close to our family, and pretty much, when we went to funerals or weddings, we always played the game, how are we related? Right? We just, okay, you're a Nagowski, I'm a Nagowski, let's try to put the tree together. Because we pretty much didn't know. Friends, you'll remember certain things that went on. I could tell you of some friends that I had in high school. I'd tell you of a friend at junior high. And it's these friends that kind of formed what was going on. Sometimes when you're going through sickness, you know, they make these memories of what you went through. You go to funerals and the same thing. Your school days where you went to school, sports, if you played in sports, all those memories, church activities, all of these things help us form memories. All of these help us come together. And as I was studying Monday, and as I went through that article, and I started studying this out, and I told the orderly service, I'm not all that sure if I didn't go off biblically, but I don't think I did. But I want you to know most of these memories, which are good memories, that you'll cherish as long as you're on this earth, end here. They're simply that. Lifelong memories. I think most of these we will not carry into heaven. I think they're used by God for His honor and His glory here. And because these memories are healthy, these memories are helpful. These memories help us make decisions that we should make for God's honor and glory. In Deuteronomy 15:15, God was giving the law and giving direction for what to do with slaves. And after 7 years, you release the slave, right? And we're not going to get into what is slavery and what isn't slavery. It's different in biblical times. There's some things that went on here. But anyway, Deuteronomy 15:15 says this: "You should remember that you were a slave in the land of Egypt, and the Lord your God redeemed you. Therefore, I command you this thing today," right? He says, hey, no, you were a slave, so help them out. And that's what memories do, right? I remember when. I mean, you ever see someone broke down the road on the side of the road and you wanted to just help because you remember when you were stuck on the side of the road? I saw this, I think it was on Fox News a couple days ago. Snoop Dogg. I don't have much by Snoop Dogg other than someone said he did a gospel album. And so that I have it. And I just downloaded it so I could listen to it. And it's interesting. It's hard for me to, you know, praise Jesus. Anyway, but they were slaves. And so he said, remember. But the one thing as they were interviewing him was Snoop Dogg always treats those who are starting out fairly and encouraging and spends time with them. And they asked him, why do you do that? He goes, I remember when I was starting out and how hard it was. And I don't want to make it hard for them. And so I thought, that's what memories do, right? If you understand the memories, then these memories help motivate us to do something. I tell you, one of the things, because I grew up in Detroit and had been robbed a couple times, my memory makes me want to be on guard at sometimes. A few years ago, we were visiting my mom, who was in the hospital, and as we were leaving the hospital, somebody got off the wall that they were sitting on and started behind us. And I looked over at Joyce. I said, Joyce, put your purse on your other arm and get on this side. And she said, why? And just then my sister-in-law said, I saw the same thing and moved my purse. And Joyce goes, why? I'm not in a mood to chase someone who may want to be just grabbing your purse and head into the thing, right? You just learn some things because where you grew up causes you to pay closer attention to the environment and the things that are going on around you. One time when I was back in Detroit, I pulled up to a stoplight and this guy was going across the street, and about halfway he started veering over to my car, and it was funny because I just locked the door and he kind of looked at me and grinned, and I just went, not today. And you know, and because when I'm in the city, this is something that might help some of y'all. When you're in the city, do not pull up to the bumper in front of you. Leave a gap. It's a better weapon if you can maneuver. But if you're boxed in, just, y'all, See, you get street smart as well as biblical smart here. Isn't that awesome? And that way you can maneuver and get around. But hopefully, the memories of God's grace, where we were, motivates us to extend God's grace to others. Because all of us are saved by God's grace. It is nothing you have done. It says, for by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourself. It's a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. God's fashioned you through salvation, but none of us deserved it. Everything in our life is by God's grace. And we need to understand that. I hope this morning everyone here knows they're a sinner. Understands fully that there is not a work you can do in order to make it to heaven. That you're insufficient to make it into God's kingdom on your own merit. God's not going to look at your good works and your bad works and go, I think he's okay. No, if you break one law of God, the Bible says we broke all of them. You fall short. But where God's grace comes in is God loves us so much that he sent his son Jesus, born in and through the Virgin Mary, lived a sinless, perfect life, and died on the cross, was buried and rose again so that we could be saved. The Bible says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. This morning, I hope you understand by God's grace, if you'll repent of your sinfulness and trusting in yourself and believe Jesus died on the cross for you, you can repent and receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. It's God's grace. This is the thing that I fully understand. If it wasn't for God's grace, there is no way in 2019, I would be preaching the Word of God. I'm not sure where my life would have went, but I know it wouldn't have been church, right? Memories, though, they fashion us. Because of that day where God saved me, there's some bad memories that also help bring us to where we are. Whether it was that you got robbed, or whether you had loving parents, or whether your parents struggled and didn't know, and it wasn't an environment that was as good, or maybe you had a situation of some sickness. All of this just kind of comes together, right? There's a lot of people who are really germophobic. I mean, germophobic. Right? Because they got sick. Don't you ever do that. You'll get sick. And it's like, no, that's not. Oh, I did. And so their whole life, right, is based on that memory. You shouldn't do something, or you should do something because of something that happened in your life. This memory just came. It's always funny to me. If my car broke down, 16, 17 at home, And you know, my car cost $200, so it broke down. And it was always funny. It could be the brakes going out. And my mom would go, are you sure it's not the radiator? Your dad's radiator just had a hole. No, it won't stop. But because she had this memory of a radiator going out, I'm supposed to check the radiator to make sure it's why I'm going into a brick wall. No, it's not. It's not. But her memory, not knowing anything about an automobile and someone saying this is it. So, there was a time I didn't want electric windows because my brother's electric windows went out. And I'm like, oh, no, you should always have crank windows, right? Until my truck had crank windows. And people would always come to the passenger side and go, like, no, I ain't reaching over there. You bring your lazy self over here so I can crank this window down, right? You bet. And just crank it down. No, it's a long ways off. Memories. They fashion who we are, how our lives are. But I got this question. Are memories eternal? Is everything here going to be remembered there? I know salvation and Jesus being Lord will. Because if you never get saved, you're never going to make it to heaven. You're not going to be able to redeem or worship and fall below, but in holiness before Jesus. I know that's eternal, right? By grace, we sing because of the Lamb of God. We talk about that in Revelation. So when we get to heaven, there's going to be this rejoicing in Jesus. But what about earthly memories? And there's some discussion. Some believe all of them should stay. But I think there's some scripture that points that all of them don't stay. I believe there's lifelong memories and they're good. And they help us here. They develop us here. But we're not going to take them into eternal memories. I believe some of the earthly things God tells us he's going to get away with. Look, go in Isaiah chapter 65 and verse 16. Isaiah 65, 16 says this, that he who blesses himself in the earth shall bless himself in the God of truth. And he that swears in the earth shall swear by the God of truth. Because the former troubles, now I want you to get this phrase, former troubles are forgotten. And because they are hid from my eyes. So God, he's talking to Israel, but it applies to heaven, and you'll see it in the next verse. That God takes away some painful things. That God takes away some troubled things in our lives. Some things that will not bring us joy before the throne of God when we get to heaven. Verse 17 says this, for behold, I create a new heaven and a new earth. The former shall not be remembered nor come into mind. And God just takes it away. Sort of like me trying to forget y'all's names. Some of those things, God just, it's crazy. I don't know. You know, isn't it weird? You know, some Nathan, I'm getting old, I'm forgetful. I just want to smack him every time a 20-some-year-old says that. But I forget to smack him, so anyway. And the former shall not be remembered nor come into mind, but be glad and rejoice forever in that which I create. For behold, I create Jerusalem a rejoicing and her people a joy. God wants it. When we get to heaven, it's going to be beyond understanding. There's going to be rejoicing and joy before the throne of God, the Lamb of God who saved us and redeemed us, and we become his children. Revelation 21:4 says this, and God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. Now get this, no more death, neither sorrow. For there to be no sorrow, some memories have to go. Or heaven would be sorrowful the whole time. Nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things, the things of this world. Now, in all the beauty and the way God blesses us here, when we get to heaven, we're going to be looking more to the things of God. The former things are passed away. And so my question is this, what are eternal memories? What are the things that I'm going to rejoice in and celebrate when I get to heaven? And what are the things that are going to be former, right? What are God going to say? Ah, no, man, you're not going to remember that. I'm sure it will be the day of salvation. We'll rejoice Yeah, I got saved. And I can tell you when I got saved, I'm so thankful that my brother drug me to church. I'm so thankful I sat in that balcony at Temple Baptist Church in Detroit. I'm so thankful that when I said, yes, I want to get saved, he made sure I come down the aisle and off to the right there. I can remember it as clear as day up until the time I received the Lord and passed out. God did a work in my life. I think for all eternity, I'll be praising God for what he did in my life. I believe the day of baptism. First obedience to Christ. We're going to baptize too after at the end of the service here. And I think you remember when, man, I told the Lord, I'm going to bury and walk in newness of life. I think God says, remember the day you said yes to me. I believe there's days when you're uniting with the local body called the church. I think we'll remember days where we sat here and we celebrated to getting baptized. I think the days we'll remember is when we sang biblically and firmly the glory of God and praised him for all that's going on. I believe you the days you praise and serve God in the church as the family. I think those days would be remembered. That God worked and God moved. The day you shine for Christ at work in school. Because you realize it's the glory of God that brought you to where you are. And you want to be an example of Christ. I think there's some days at schools you're going to remember. And some days you're just not going to remember at all. I believe God's going to take away the sorrow and the pain, the days you shared Christ. Folks got saved. The day you walked through the valley with Jesus and he delivered you. I believe these things will be real and they'll be eternal. We continue with some examples. Because Adam and Eve, I believe God will block their sinful act. I don't think we're all going to be in heaven going, that's Adam, that's Eve. They messed this whole thing up, right? Because they would, like, God, just give me a corner somewhere where no one knows where I'm at. Right? Wouldn't it be a bummer to be Adam and Eve all the way through heaven? Now, God does say he's going to give us a new name. So, hey, you know, hey, what were you in, you know, down on earth? Well, you know, what's your alias, right? I don't know. But listen, I'm sure those things are going to be gone because we're looking to the glory of God. If not, Adam and Eve is going to have a rough time in heaven because how many people want to go, what's up? Right? Noah, I think Noah remember being faithful to God, building an ark. I think that'd be something we celebrate where God, listen, the rainbow is a reminder of God's promise. Don't let anyone rob it. It's God's promise of his faithfulness, is God's promise of working. I think we'll be able to say, I think Peter will remember walking on the water. I was on the Sea of Galilee, and I'm telling you, when you're on the Sea of Galilee, you want to jump out the boat. They tell you not to jump out the boat. I think they tell you not, because I'm pretty sure I was at the exact spot where Jesus was, and if I jumped out, I'd walk. I wanted to. Because wouldn't it be cool? No, I'm walking ashore. Y'all go on. I don't want to be out here anymore. Peter, God, why do we focus on the negative of Peter taking his eyes off of Jesus and sinking and not go, that dude walked on water. That should be something that celebrates us. Look at what Billy Graham says about this. More than that, God has promised that in heaven, nothing, even the memory of this world's sin and pain, will cast a shadow over the joy he has in store for us there. Think about that for a moment. In this world, even the memory of what someone did to us years ago can still cause us pain. Amen? I mean, well, they did, and it does. But that won't be true in heaven because our focus won't be on the past because some of them are going to be gone, but on Christ and what he means to us. And so we spend a lot of time on earthly memories. And I'm not saying earthly memories are bad, But I'm telling you, they're not as valuable as storing up treasures of eternal memories. Paul remembered the bright light, I'm sure. I'm sure he's going, man, I remember when God got a hold of my heart. I hope right now God's showing you when you got saved. Because that should be something you'll never lose sight of. Remember, the church is planted all over the world. I'm sure Paul's like, no, man, the church at Corinth, bunch of heathens, but God used me to save them. I don't think Saul's name will ever be remembered. Saul to Paul is a testimony here. And listen, the memory of what you were, don't downplay it. It ain't any good in heaven, but it's a praise to God's glory and honor here. I used to be a Saul, now I'm Paul. You used to be a Saul, but now you're Paul. It's just going to be Paul in heaven. I don't know what his new name might be, but God already gave him, from Saul to Paul, some examples. I think in heaven, I really think the Lord may come up and say, remember when you shared the gospel at the fair? You didn't think it was any good, but these three got saved. And there were some people this week for the first time in public shared the gospel. Isn't that cool? Because it's hard to stand before a group of people and go, hey, you're a sinner. Jesus loves you, died for you. You need to get saved. And it's cool. Listen, and we don't ever know what's going to happen. Paula, there was these two twins and at the fair, and they hung out at our booth. They were 6 years old, and they were wearing the same dress. And there's just cute little girls just running around crazy. And for a while there, it's like, where are your parents? Well, their parents were a few booths down and just kind of let them play at the fair. Now, I don't know about you. I have trouble, 6-year-old, just playing at the fair. But this one girl, she was there hours, I guess. And so she kept talking, and we kept talking. And all of a sudden, she's coming back and hugging me. And I'm like, man, y'all know me. Apparently, the grandfather vibe is a true thing. Because she's just like, woo. I think she thought I had money. Anyway, she's hugging me, and she keeps talking to me. And then we're sitting down, and she comes in there where I'm sitting down, and she goes, you need to come to my house. I'm like, I have two dogs, I got these three cats, and I'm like, well, I'm allergic to cats. We'll lock them in Mama's bathroom. I was like, okay, this girl got this thing figured out. And then when we were closing up, she wanted me to come hang out at her mom's booth, and I'm like, I am worn out, I am going home, I don't know. But you never know. If God will take that in that 6-year-old girl, that she got something, and later on she gets saved. You don't know how the gospel, right, gets shared and how God uses it for his honor and for his glory. Now, I didn't have all good moments at the fair. And I'll leave that there. He's recording. The Lord to you. Thanks for feeding my sheep, the word. They served me because of you. You know, some of y'all have taught Sunday school forever, and I praise God for that. Don't lose sight of these eternal victories that you, when you get to heaven, it'll be there for you because you fed his sheep, and these people remembered what you did. The Lord says, thanks for VBS. Many got saved. I'm not talking the four that got saved this week. We don't know how many over the years when we do VBS and we give them the gospel that get saved. Jesus is at work. Those memories, I think, are going to go on. Thanks for working hard in your secular job and using your money as my money for my glory. I'm so thankful for that. Some of y'all, God has blessed financially in business. God has blessed you, and you know it's God that has given you the mind. God has given you the talent. God has given you the skill. God has used you, and you use it for him. There's nothing wrong using it to create memories. I think you should take your preacher along when you go to some of these places to take memories. That way you'll have a memory of going, why was he here? And it'll be funnier at the end. I don't know, he just kept going. Everywhere we went, he jumped in the car. Memories. But God has blessed you. Isn't it fascinating how some people can use a hammer and some people you laugh at when they use a hammer? It's just, some people just don't have certain skills. It's God blessing you, and if he's blessed you and you use it for his honor and for his glory, I think those memories will stay there. The Lord to you, thanks for working hard for making church family time a priority. I think family time, but I think church family time is something you remember. See, I want you to understand, I think there's going to be some things God won't let us remember. I don't think we're going to get to heaven, and if we had a lost relative, we're ever going to remember that lost relative. I can't imagine the sorrow of going, I can't believe they're not here for all eternity. See, I'm thankful, and this whole thing makes me want to even ask my kids and make sure they're saved, because I don't want it to be an earthly memory and not an eternal memory. And as I was doing this, I thought for a minute, what if I hope Ellie and Kason, I said it right. Be sad to mess up there. Kason, what if they don't get saved? Because I already have some precious memories. But I'm sure for all eternity, God's not going to let me remember they aren't here. See, I think some painful things God's going to remove. See, some of the things you're working on, good memories here. But I just want you to know they're not going to be memories there. This is what it says in 1 Corinthians 3:13 and 14. Every man's work shall be made manifest. Now I want you to know, for a short time in heaven, you're not going to forget anything. You're going to have supersonic memory. God says every idle word is going to be judged. Now, we don't stand as Christians, if you're saved, you don't stand before the white throne judgment. But you're judged for the works, the deeds done in the body, right? And so this is, every man's work shall be manifest. It's going to be revealed. It's going to be shown. For the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire. And the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. So in other words, is this going to be treasures laid up in heaven? Or is this going to be something that's just abolished? If any man's work abide, in other words, make it through, you shall build thereupon, you shall receive a reward. If any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss. I believe it's gone. You'll never even think about it anymore for all eternity. He shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. So there's this time. God's going to kind of, you're going to remember it all. Then we're going to enter into our eternal glory with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And those things are going to be done away with. Transition here at church had me thinking on this. I want you to know, ending some things around here is way harder than starting things. It's difficult. If you wrestle with it, I just want you to know I wrestle with it 1,000 times more. Hate it. But sometimes you got to change something or do something because God just wants you. Because we can't be attached to the thing, we're attached to the Lord. I mean, it even went to the point where I was just wondering, is it my time to transition? Because the last thing I ever want to do is stand in the way of what God wants to do and what God desires to do. I mean, all these things, it's like, people leaving. You know, I used to be, when I first started ministry, I used to play this godly game. Well, that's all right. We'll be praying for you. I'm glad God's leading. No, it hurts. I tell you, everyone who's ever left anything I've ever done, it's stinking liars. They said they were with me to the end. Fleshly. Spiritually, I know God moves people. But physically, like, dumb liar. Just being honest. But God works. And I know God moves people. I'm not saying He doesn't. But this is where I had to come. And so God just kind of refocused me, holding to the eternal memories, to those things that are eternal. Right? Because all those things we did for God are still eternal. Memories may shift, but what we did for the Lord when we get to heaven, we'll still be able to praise God for what He's done. And this will help all of us, releasing the temporal. See, several of us struggle within our mind of those temporal things that aren't going to last, that we just can't let go. And we need to leave those at the Lord's feet and say, this is here. These memories are forming who I am, but they're only temporal. One day I'm released from all of it. God works. I don't know about you. I want to put into perspective what memory will be burned up. And I want to hold on to what memories will celebrate. And I want to focus on the eternal. Because I think laying up treasures in heaven is not just about getting rewards. But we'll get to rejoice for all eternity next to someone we led to the Lord. Next to someone we encouraged and discipled. Next to someone who is about to forsake the Lord. We're able to help bring back. And God says, I've used you and I'm going to continue to use you for God's honor. And for God's glory. I don't know about you. I'm ready to make more eternal memories. Are you? Some of y'all have a lot of memories. That when we get to the grave, it's done. I know I have some. And so God calls us to start making some more eternal memories. To how God desires to work and to move in our lives. I ask that you stand with your heads bowed and eyes closed. Attitude of prayer. I'm going to ask those who are getting ready for baptism if you'll head off. Mark's going to be up front here. And I just ask that you come and say, hey, I don't know if I'm saved. He'll be happy to find someone to help you walk through the Word of God and find out if you're saved. But some of y'all are just bent on making earthly memories. You think just making any memory is okay. I want to challenge you. Are you making burned up earthly memories more than you're making eternal memories that will last forever? God, just search your heart out. And whatever's standing in the way of you making eternal memories with your Heavenly Father, would you just give that to Him today and allow Him to work? Father, we praise you and thank you for what you're doing. I thank you, Father, that we get to celebrate who you are. Lord, right now, help us to make eternal memories of your honor.
If you'd like to find out more information or keep up to date on what's happening here at Memorial Baptist Church, you can visit us at our website, www.mbcnewhaven.com, where you can find our weekly bulletin, our church calendar, and also previous sermons. You can also find us on Facebook, YouTube, and also our Church Link app. All that information is on our website, so come on by, check it out, and thank you for joining us.